Good morning to all of you. We are going to discuss the case law on revenue land, particularly the prohibitory sale of the land under section 22A of the Registration Act. Here, Honorable Single Judge M. Gangarao of Andhra Pradesh High Court has come down heavily on the collector of East Godavari District for relying on the webland records and not on the factual report of the Tahsildar of Rajahmundry Rural, and simply denying the MeSeva application of the applicant. So the collector has been asked to reconsider the issue. So what happened? Normally, since it is a revenue related matter, a little bit confusing for the ordinary people. As such, I have consulted Sri N.V. Narasaya, retired Tahsildar, and also who was educating my batchmate, and got clarification from him, and then only I am doing this video. Right? Because I am not an expert in revenue matters, that's why I have to take in the assistance, I have to thank him also, that's why openly I am telling this. So please remember, rejecting MeSeva application by relying solely on the webland records and the assignment proceedings of D Farm Patta and not considering the revenue report and revenue records is not allowed, and actually the issue, the rejection memo is totally illegal, it is waived, and the collector is asked to once again reconsider the same. Right, here if you go to the brief facts of the case, the petitioner is a resident of Rajahmundry. Of course, this land is located in survey number 367 of an extent of 11.6 acres in a village called Kolamuru, which is just in the outskirts of Rajahmundry town. So Kolamuru, Kontamuru, on the way to Rajanagaram also, you can see those villages, very fertile land villages. So whatever it is, here, please remember, there is this, in this particular survey number 367. This land has actually declared as a government land, government Porambuk land, and it is named as Kankara Gutta Sthalamu. But of course, it was later reclassified as a government dry land, and it was allotted to Sri Chavali Ramamurthy Shastri in 1933. So you may be knowing, so there is a fixed, according to certain GO, there is a fixed cut-off date, that is 18-6-1954. So if any land was registered, maybe assigned land, whatever, assigned lands particularly, assessed wastelands they call, if it is registered to any private person, if it is handed over to any private person before 18-6-1954, then it is his land and not government land. So this is what happened here. In 1933 itself, it was given to Mr. Masudan Chavali Rama Masudan Shastri, and for here a lot of transactions have taken place. Definitely he might have sold it to some persons. Ultimately this has come into the possession of this particular petitioner. Right, so now he filed a writ petition number WP number 15305/2020, so requiring a writ of mandamus from the High Court against the orders of the district collector Rajahmundry, arrest collector, East Godavari, Kakinada. Right, so here the main points we have to learn is, suppose if it is assessed waste land, normally the revenue people, so they will categorize five areas of lands and declare them as prohibitory lands, and once the communication was sent to the registration people, they will not register the lands according to section 22A. Here this is actually a land relating to assignment land. Actually, this actually we can call it as annexure 2, Porambuku or Roadlu, Kuntalu. So these are Pakka government lands according to that. But what happened is, before 1954 itself, this was handed over to another person who has done so many transactions. So it cannot be called as a prohibitory land, right? And when the petitioner has approached the collector through MeSeva application. He has filed an application under MeSeva, and actually he requested the collector to delete the particular area as number 367 because he purchased about 150 square feet and he wanted to dispose something. So he wanted the deletion of this from the probate lands. Unless they delete, the registrar will not register the lands, right? So there's normally the official procedure follows. They ask the collector, ask the tahsildar's report. But please remember, the tahsildar, being the ground level officer, he has reported the matter very correctly. He has stated that no doubt it was Kankarakunta Stalam, but in 1933 itself is handed out to Shastri. So there is a GO also, according to GO number 575, dated 16-11-2018. The government has also given directions. Please don't make such mistakes stating that this is in Poramok land, probatory order, all these things. You verify the facts that RSR register 1908 and then only come up with the report. So as per that GO also, so this is not a prohibited land. So the land may be deleted like that, deleted from the list of probatory he has recommended. But basing on the report of the sub-collector, normally Rajahmundry sub-collector will be there. So normally we also know that these young officers, they will be under the impression that the juniors, they are in other way, they are collusive or politically traded or corrupt, all these things. So normally the sub-collector did not recommend the version of the tahsildar, and he said, basing on the web land, this land belongs to government, finish. So it should be kept in probatory. So simply the collector also, for basing on the opinion of the sub-collector and also web land records, he stated that he cannot give deletion orders. Ultimately, the matter has come to the court. So court, basing on the GO and also the other connected reports and also the report of the tahsildar, stated that it is absolutely not correct for the collector simply believing the web land records or revenue records and the proceedings in the BD format, all these things. Whether you have gone to the ground report that is submitted by tahsildar or not, since it is wrong, so the collector is directed to once again reconsider. Once again, he has to go through the entire record and he has to, of course, there is no other go for him except to delete the so-called survey number 367 from the probate lands. Very good judgment. Please, this will be useful for the revenue, particularly if a revenue dispute is there. So many things are coming. Simply they say it is kept in the probate orders. You delete it, then only we will register. Otherwise, the registrar office will not at all take any initiative. So for this man has to go to the level of High Court. Please review the case, very WP number 15305 by 2020, decided on 4-6-2021 by Justice Gangarao. Very good judgment. Please follow it. Thank you very much.